This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, everyone. Is it audible? Good morning, everyone. Jyoti Prakash.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, today's class will be on Health for All by 2000. That is the slogan given by WHO. So these are the WHO's president at that point of time. So Health for All, the slogan Health for All was given by the World Health Organization in the year 1977, May. So mainly they want to provide all the healthcare services to all the people across the world. So they wrote the slogan Health for All by 2000 AD. So it was started in by WHO in the year 1977. May. You can see the headquarters of WHO, that is Geneva. So the goal of, what is the goal of this WHO? So they want to make health for all is the main social goal of government as well as WHO. So all the governments, what they have to do is they have to provide healthcare services to all the people who are living in their states. So all the state governments in the entire country, in the entire world, the main aim of the government is to provide healthcare services to all the people who are living in their respective countries. So they came out with a definition. So what is health for all? So what will be their aim? So they came out with a definition, that is, it is the attainment by all the people of the world by the year 2080, a level of health that will permit them to lead a socially and economically productive life. So overall, what they want to give is they want to give a socially good life and economically productive life. That means they must be in a position to earn something, to do some jobs and earn something for their daily routine. So everybody must be healthy. They must be active socially and they must be involved in some of the activities, in some of the economic activities, so that they can earn something and they can have productive life. So that is the main definition or main aim of WHO. It is the level of health. To which extent it is a level of health that will permit them to lead a socially and economically productive life. So socially, they must be sound. Socially, they must be very good with all the society. They must have good interaction with the relatives, surroundings, neighbors and everyone. And economically, they must be in a position to earn something and they must lead a productive life. So that is the main goal of WHO by the year 2000 AD. So this goal has come to popularly known as Health for All by 2000 AD. So this goal has become very popular. It has become very popular and it has commonly known as Health for All by 2000 AD. Now, what is the background of this philosophy? So why they want to go for Health for All by 2000 AD? You can see the background of this philosophy was the unacceptability, low levels of health status of the world population, especially the rural poor, and gross disparities in the health between the rich and poor, urban and rural population. Just if you look at the geography clearly, you can understand that. You can see. So what we say is majority of the people in India are living in villages. Majority, most of the population in India are living in rural areas, whereas minority of the people are living in urban areas. when you look at the healthcare services, when you look at the healthcare services, if you at the rural areas, we are saying that population is very, very high, but healthcare services are very, very less. You can see, you will not find a super specialty hospital, or you will not find a super specialist or a specialist in rural areas, or the number of hospitals will be very less in the rural areas, but the population of rural area is very high. Whereas when you come back to the urban areas, population is very, very less, but you are getting all the district hospitals are there, medical college hospitals are there, super specialty hospitals are there, but the population is very, very less. See the disparity, see the difference. You can observe the difference between the urban and rural areas. So in the rural areas, what we say is, in India, majority of the population are living in rural areas. Most of the population in India are living in rural areas. But the healthcare services to those people who are in majority, we are providing very, very less healthcare facilities to them. But when it comes to the urban area, the population living in urban area is very, very less. And moreover, the services provided in the urban area are very, very high. Like you can see, the district hospitals are there in the urban area, medical college hospitals are there, super specialty hospitals are there, and different types of nursing homes are there, both private as well as government, public as well as private hospitals are more in urban areas. So that is the very good disparity you can observe between the rural and urban areas. And one more thing is that the services provided to the poor is very less. If you go to the government hospital, the services are very, very poor. Even they don't have drugs, they don't have cotton, they don't have infrastructure properly, they don't have the proper washing facilities, they don't have the proper staying facilities, or they don't have the proper facilities in the government. Whereas if you see the rich people, they will go to the private hospitals where the services are very good. So this is the main reason why they want to go for Health for All 2080 is that, so all the healthcare services must be equally distributed in the society, irrespective of caste, creed, and money. So the main aim of Health for All by 2000 is that all healthcare facilities, what are healthcare facilities are available in India or in the entire world, all the services must be equally distributed, is irrespective of caste, religion, creed, or money. Right, everybody has the right to ask for health. So they can ask for their health, they can ask the government, and they can get whatever the services they want. So that's why what they have done is they brought a new slogan or a new definition that is called Health for All. That is a level of health that will permit them to lead a socially and economically productive life. So health status of the world population, especially the rural poor, and gross disparities in the health between the rich and poor, urban and rural population. So I clearly explained. So in urban areas, majority of the population are living, but the healthcare services are very, very poor. Whereas in urban areas, the minority of the population are living, whereas they are having the high healthcare facilities. So that disparity has to go. And second one is, for poor people, only government services are available, and that too in the government, there are a lack of facilities are there, infrastructure is not there, manpower is not there, drug supply is not there, so many constraints or so many problems are there for the poor people. Whereas for the rich people, they can go to the private hospitals, they can get whatever they want, whatever facilities they want, whatever treatment they want, they can approach directly to the super specialties, so they get the treatment. So this disparity they want to reduce. Health for All means, so all the healthcare services must be equally distributed among across all the people in the entire world. They may be rich, they may be poor, they may be different religions, they may be different castes, or they may be economically sound or economically poor. Whatever it may be, all the healthcare services must be equally distributed among the population. That's why they have taken a slogan that is called as Health for All by 2000. So the concept of Health for All is that the essential concept of equity in health, that is, all people should have an opportunity to enjoy good health. So the point is very clear here. So everybody must have an opportunity to enjoy good health. That means it is the right of the people to ask for health. It is the right of the people to ask for the facilities, to ask for the manpower, to ask for the hospitals, to ask for the for providing good healthcare services in their locality. So everybody must be, the health services must be equally distributed among all the sectors of the population. Healthcare services must be equally distributed among all sectors of the population, irrespective of caste, creed, or money. So what is the global strategy? So in 1981, a global strategy for health for all was evolved by WHO. So they made a global strategy in 1981 that was evolved by WHO. So what they say is, all member states and flexible enough to be adapted to national and regional variations of conditions and requirements. So in different countries, different socio-demographic profiles will be there. So that's why what they have to do is, they have given, WHO has given broad guidelines, and those guidelines, based on your socio-economic development of each country, they have to modify the broad guidelines, and they have to simplify them, and they have to adopt them, and they have to implement the strategies in their respective countries. So the global strategy provides a global framework that is broad enough to apply to all member states and flexible enough to be adapted to national and regional variations of conditions and requirements. So based on the socio-demographic profile of each and every country, they have to modify the global strategies according to their countries. They have to simplify them, and they have to adopt them, and they have to implement the guidelines in their own countries. So what each state has to do is, they have to own their strategies for achieving health for all, and synthesis of national strategies for developing regional strategies. So every country has to adopt the global strategy, and they have to modify it according to their conditions and situations. They have to simplify it, adopt it, and they have to implement the policy in their respective countries. So the WHO has established 12 global indicators as the basic point of reference for assessing the progress towards health for all. So they have made out 12 global indicators, and based on that, they want to assess whether they have achieved the health for all by 2000 AD or not. So what is the national strategy for health for all by 2000? So as a signatory to the Almeta Declaration in 1978, so Almeta Declaration happened in 1978. So the government of India was committed to taking steps to providing health for all to its citizens by 2000 AD. So by 2000 AD, the government of India has taken a decision that definitely we are going to achieve health for all by 2000 AD. That this has happened in 1978 in Almeta. So in according to this, they have made a lot of changes, a lot of strategies, suitable strategies they have framed out, and the approaches they have framed, and they have tried to achieve health for all by 2000. So they have related this national health the health for all by 2000 AD with the national health policy. That is, the national health policy echoes the WHO call for health for all and the Almeta Declaration. It has laid down specific goals in respect of the various health indicators by different dates, such as 1990 and 2000 AD. So what we have done is, we have made a national health policy in taking into consideration of the strategies of health for all by 2000 AD, and both were mixed. So both were almost similar. The national health policy echoes the WHO call for health for all. So both were same, and we have followed certain guidelines, certain goals in respect of the various health indicators by different dates, such as 1990 and 2000 AD. And were the foremost among the goals to be achieved by 2000 AD were reduction of infant mortality rate from the level of 125 in 1978. Infant mortality rate is almost 125. per thousand population to below 60. That is almost 50% we want to reduce by 2000 AD. That is the most important goal is reduction of infant mortality rate from the level of 125 to below 60. So in 1978, what is the reason for infant mortality rate that is 125 per thousand population? Because of communicable diseases. Because of communicable diseases, especially plague, cholera. So those are the most dangerous diseases at that point of time, and those are having higher mortalities at that point of time because they don't have the proper treatment or proper preventive strategies were not there. As a result of that, IMR was very high at that point of time. That is almost 125 deaths per thousand live births. So infant mortality rate is very high. That is 125, and we want to reduce it by 2000 to 60 to below 60 per thousand live births. That is almost 50%. We have to halve it. You see, in 1978, the life expectancy was almost 52 years only. In 1978, you see, the life expectancy was only at the level of 52 years. And we want to rise it to 64 years by 2000 AD. So at that point of time, I told you, because the communicable diseases were rampant and they are causing higher mortality. So we don't know whether every individual will have very good life at up to the age of 60 years or not, but majority they died at the age of 52, maximum life expectancy. So at that point of time, the maximum life expectancy was only 52 years. Because of communicable diseases, mortality was very high, right? So what they want to do is they want to suppress the communicable diseases. They want to get control over the communicable diseases and see that they want to improve the life expectancy to up to 64 years by the year 2000 AD. And if you look at the crude death rate, so you see the crude death rate is at the level of 14 per thousand population to 9 per thousand population. So at that point of time, the crude death rate, crude means it includes all, it may be due to diseases, accidents, or some other reasons, or due to maybe calamities or whatever it may be. So all will come under crude. It is not due to specific reason. They have not specifically mentioned that or you can say it is infant mortality rate or under 5 mortality rate or adult mortality, adolescent mortality, like that they have not mentioned. Crude means you have to consider all age groups and all types. It may be because of accidents, it may be because of heart attacks, it may be due to systemic diseases, it may be due to calamities, or it may be due to communicable any other communicable disease or non-communicable disease, whatever it may be, all will come under crude, irrespective of age and sex. They have not mentioned. So overall, what is happening is at that point of 1978, the scenario is like that. The crude death population. So that means for every thousand population, for every thousand population, 14 people were dying. So they want to reduce that to 9 per thousand population by the year 2000 AD. So they have taken different steps to overcome this. How to reduce the crude death rate? How to reduce the death rate among different age categories or from different causes? How to reduce them, and what are the strategies they have to apply and they have made out? So at that point of time, especially in 1978, the crude death rate was 14 per thousand population. So they want to reduce that 14 to 9 per thousand population by the year 2000 AD. So that is the most important goal they are having at that point of time. And if you look at the fourth point, to reduce the crude birth rate from the level of 33 per thousand population to 21. So at that point of time, birth rate was very high, and it is almost 33 per thousand population, and they want to reduce that birth rate also to 21 per thousand population. So for that also, they have taken up lot of steps, lot of family planning programs, lot of contraceptives, lot of family planning programs they have brought to reduce the birth rate also. And finally, what they want to do is they to achieve a net production rate of one. So finally, their main aim is to get the NNR of one, net reproduction rate of one is they want to achieve NNR to be at one. So these are the five goals, just go through. So Health for All by 2000 AD, their main aim is to reduce IMR, that is infant mortality level, from 125 to 60. Infant mortality rate from 125 to 16, mainly because of communicable diseases, especially plague and cholera, which are highly fatal at that point of time. So they want to control those communicable diseases and see that IMR must be reduced, that is below 60 they want to bring. And the main thing is mortality was very high due to communicable diseases, and the life expectancy was only 52 at that point of time, and they want to rise, they want to control the communicable diseases and increase the life expectancies to 64 years. And moreover, they want to reduce the crude death rate, that is at that point of time it was 14 per thousand population, and they want to bring back to 9 per thousand population. And next one is to reduce the crude birth rate from the level of 33 per thousand population to 21. So at that point of time, the birth rate was 33 per thousand population. Slowly they brought a lot of programs, national programs, family welfare programs, a lot of schemes, contraceptives, a lot of things they brought into the society. As a result of that, this birth rate has come down to achieve a net reproduction rate of one. So the finally what they want to do is, they want that the net reproduction rate should be one. And then the sixth point is to provide portable water to the entire rural population, because at that point of time, waterborne diseases are very high, and they are causing high mortality rates at that point of time. And they want to see that every individual in each and every village, they will get portable water, and the water which is suitable for drinking, they want to supply to the entire rural population. So to provide portable water to the entire rural population, this is also one of the goal of Health for All by 2000 AD. So these are the 6 points which you have to keep in mind: reduce IMR, reduce crude birth rate, reduce crude death rate, and then provide to achieve net production rate of one, and then to provide potable water in rural places. Most important points of Health for All 2000 you have to keep in mind. So what is the national strategy for Health for All? So we discussed the goals broadly, and now what is our plan or a national strategy for Health for All? So the government of India recognized and strengthened the infrastructure, implement primary health care. The infrastructure is as follows. You can see village health post they have developed. So in plain area there is one village health post for every 1,000 population, and in hilly and tribal areas for 500 population one village health post will be there. So to implement these strategies, that the state, the national government or the central government has taken up certain steps. Among them, village health post is one, that is in plain area if there is one village health post for every 1,000 population, and hilly and tribal areas for every 500 population there will be one village health post, and in each village health post is manned by one trained birth attendant and one village health guide will be there. So in village health post there will be one trained birth attendant and one village health guide will be there. There is also one Anganwadi worker, so in each village Anganwadi workers will be there. And second one is sub center. You can see sub center will be there for every 5,000 population. If it is a hilly or tribal area, for every 2,500 to 3,000 population there will be one sub center. So each sub center is managed by one health worker female, auxiliary nurse midwife, and one health worker male, and one part time attendant. So in each sub center there will be one health worker female and one health worker male, and ANM will be there and one part-time health attendant will be there. And they developed primary health centers. They had developed primary health centers. So each health center will be, for every 30,000 population there will be one primary health center in plain areas, and one PHC for every 25,000 population in tribal and hilly areas. You can see the PHC staffing. That is medical officer, one medical officer will be there, nurse midwife one will be there, pharmacist, health assistant female, health assistant male one. PHC has 4 to 6 beds and some diagnostic facilities will be available. And then block extension educator will be there, health worker female, lab technician will be there, UDC and LDC, driver, class 4 employees one. Total staff in the primary health center will be 15 members. Please go through, you have to keep in mind so it may come in your examination. Staffing of the PHC, PHC staffing, you can see medical officer one, nurse midwife one, pharmacist one, health assistant female one, health assistant male one. PHC has 4 to 6 beds and some diagnostic facilities will be there. Block extension educator one, health worker female one, lab technician one, UDC and LDC will be there, driver one, class 4 employees 4 will be there, and total 15 members staff will be there in the primary health center. So these are the steps taken up by the central government to follow the strategy given by the WHO of health for all by 2000 AD. And then community health centers, so they have established community health center. So there is a provision of one community health center for each block with a population of 80 to 1,20,000. So for community health centers will be for every 80,000 to 1,20,000, there will be one community health center. That center will have 30 beds and provides medical, surgical, obstetrical and gynecological and pediatric services. So community health center will be established for every 80,000 to 1,20,000 population. It gives all the specialty services like medical, surgical, gynecological and pediatric services. The staffing pattern is as follows. You can see medical officers 4, nurse midwife 7, pharmacist compounder 1, dresser 1, lab technician 1, radiographer 1, ward boys, OB, sweepers, mali, chowkidar, aya. So these are all the staff. Almost 25 persons will be there in the 25 persons will be there in the community health center. So please keep in mind, at primary health center only primary preventive services will be given. Primary healthcare centers preventive services will be given, only little bit of curative services. Whereas in case of community health center, all the specialties like gynecology, pediatrics, general surgery, and medical specialties are available in the community health center. So they will provide treatment. All treatment services will be given, curative services will be given at the community health center. All the preventive services will be provided at the primary health center. That means patient care will be taken. Patient care will be taken up at the community health center because of the availability of specialty services. That is gynecology, pediatrics, anesthesia, general surgery and general medicine. So all the services will be available at the community health center. That's why patient care will be taken up at the community health centers. Whereas at the primary health centers, only medical officer will be there. He will be implementing all the programs as well as the preventive services to all the people, and a little bit curative services will be provided at the primary health center level. And what they have done is, because the urban area, there are a lot of slums are there. So this urban area, the indicators are very, very poor when compared to the rural area. So they want to develop this urban slums also. As a result of that, what they have done is they started urban posts in urban slums. That is, there is a provision of one urban post for every 5,000 population in urban slums. Urban health post, that is called as urban health post. There is a provision of one post for every 5,000 population in urban slums. Primary health care packages, you can see primary health care are packages which is considered suitable and accepted for health for all by 2000 AD is under universal promotion. You can see at the primary health center, the services provided are universal promotion of promotive, preventive and basic curative services. Please remember, at the primary health center, only medical officer with MBBS qualification will be available. That's why the services provided at the primary health center will be 99% promotive, preventive, and 1% basic curative services. And health education of the people. So education, health education of regarding diseases, diet, nutrition, and all those things will be given at the primary health center. Immunizations and the national programs all will be followed at the primary health centers. Healthcare services to vulnerable groups of people, that is children and women, eligible couples, etc. Prevention and control of endemic communicable diseases. So at the primary health center, they are going to control the endemic diseases and they are going to take up the antenatal, postnatal, as well as the children and the eligible couples. Healthcare services will be provided. Promotion of food supply, I mean improvement of nutritional status, that is all promotive and preventive aspects they are going to look at the primary health center. Provision of protected water supply and sanitary disposal of excreta. So I told you one of the key goal of health for all by is providing potable water to all the rural population. That is also one of the goal of health for all by 2018. That's why what they have done is provision of protected water supply and sanitary disposal of excreta. That is how to protect the water and how to disinfect the water. So before that, primary health centers, doctor will go to the well or near he used to do the chlorination of water. After testing it only, it has to be supplied to all the people who are living in that particular village. So previously it was there, now they have removed it. So to protect the people from the waterborne diseases, so what they have done is chlorination of the water. That is a major work that has to be looked after by the primary health center. So they do the chlorination and supply the water to all the houses in that particular primary health center locality. So that was there previously, now it is not there. And sanitary disposal of excreta. So excreta must be disposed safely without any problem. And then finally, family welfare services. So all the contraceptives and family welfare services, whatever are available at the primary health center or the national programs which are running by the central government. So all the services will be provided to all the people in that particular locality. So these are the functions of the primary health center. And what are the requisites for health for all? So what are the main requisites? A political commitment. So politicians, they are the main people who are responsible for bringing them into action, for allocating the budget, for making the policy, as well as allocating the resources and supporting the state governments. The central government has to make the policy, allocate the budget, and see that all the state governments must follow them, implement them, adopt them. If any changes are there, that has to be made as per the local governments, and those policy must be strictly implemented in their respective states. So political commitment plays an important role here. So if they go to Almeta if they go to Almeta conference and say that we will do it, and they come back here, if they don't take up the policy and if they don't allocate the budget to that policy, then we cannot achieve anything. That's why political commitment is very important. So the central government has to take up the policy, design the policy properly, and then allocate the budget to the policy properly, and then it has to be distributed to all the states, and the state government has to take the proper steps. And then they have to implement it thoroughly in the entire states so that we can achieve health for all by 2000. And then second one is community participation. So previously health means only doctors are responsible or paramedical staff are responsible for promoting health or prevention activities or curing the patients like that. This was the thought in the entire society. So it is not like that. Nowadays what they have done is community participation. So they are keeping the people's health in people's hand. So we are going into the community, we are selecting the people from the community and asking them to participate in all the programs. Like you can see in Pulse Polio program, everybody is involved, teachers, doctors, lawyers, political leaders, and then celebrities. Whoever is interested, they can come forward and participate. Maybe they may spend some time in the program, or they may give some money, they may contribute some money to the program, or they may give some resources, maybe in the form of benches, chairs, or they may allocate some space or time or money or whatever form, the programs will become successful, so that we can spread the program easily into the community, so that the program becomes successful. So now the main point is that community participation is very, very important for the success of each and every program. Now the slogan is keeping the people's health in people's hand. We are explaining them, we are allowing them to involve in all the programs. We are allowing them to involve, starting from planning, programming, budgeting, implementing, and then evaluation in all the aspects. In all the aspects, we are asking the community to participate and see and help us, so that the program can reach to the millions of the people, and so that they can get the benefit out of that program. So that's why community participation is very, very important for each and every program. And then support of health related sectors. The third point is support of health related sectors. So definitely, if you are working on a nutrition, so the agriculture department must come forward and explain them that what are the cheap ingredients available, so that you can get high proteins and nutrients very easily at a very cheaper cost, or what are the nutritious material or nutritious food that is available in that particular locality. Then the nutrition department or the agriculture department must be knowing, and they must come forward and they must create awareness among the public about the nutrient content of the food that is available in that particular area, so that people can consume them. People can consume that and improve their nutrition. So we have to get maybe support of health related sectors. That is, education system is there, so you can go to the schools, take the help of the teachers and ask them to weigh the height and weight, measure the BP. You can train the teachers and ask them to participate, so that they can take up the height and weight and BP of the child every once in a month or once in 3 months, like that, so that you can identify the malnutrition student very easily, or you can identify the hypertension student easily, or you can identify any other vitamin deficiencies very easily, and you can treat them properly. So what we need is we need to get help from all the related sectors. It is not that only the health department will do it. Health related sectors, it may be education sector, or it may be agriculture sector, or it may be engineering sector, or waterworks sector, or whatever may be. So all the sectors must cover and unite their hands, so that we can take forward this Health for All by 2080. So there are three requisites are there. Number one is political commitment. Unless political commitment is not there, policy will not come into force, and budget will not be allocated, and the program will not run. And then community participation, the latest slogan is that keeping the people's health in people's hand, keeping the people's health in people's hand. So the people has to come and participate from planning level, planning, budget, programming, evaluating, and then assessing, and then re-implementing. So in all the aspects, we are involving the community, and we are taking the decisions from the community, and our community must participate in all the programs, so that the program will become successful. And then support of health related sectors, I told you, like agriculture, education, waterworks, engineering, everybody must come forward. Not only the doctors, the health related sectors, all sectors must come hand into hand, and then they have to give their suggestions, they have to participate in the programs and see that all the programs must become successful. That is nothing but intersectoral coordination. In one way, you can say that intersectoral coordination must be there. So what are the special goals for Health for All by 2080? You can see the specific goals. By 1983, infant mortality rate is almost 125. So we want to bring that to below 60. Preschool child rate, that is 24, and we want to bring that to 10. Crude death rate, that is 14, we want to bring that to 9. Maternal mortality rate, that is 4.5, we want to bring that to below 2. So maternal mortality was very high, that is almost 5 members. That is almost 5 members because of complications, because of anemia, because of postpartum complications. So majority were dying at that point of time. Now what we have done, we have brought up 24 hours community health centers, blood bank facilities are available. We developed blood bank facilities, we brought up programs, RCH1 and RCH2. So that's why now it is almost below 2. So at that point of time, life expectancy at birth to males was only 52.6. Now we want to make it to 64. Females 51.6, we want to make it to 64, and crude birth rate, it is 35, we want to bring back to 21. Annual growth rate is 2.33, now we want to bring back to 1.22. So net reproduction rate at that point of time, that is 1983, it is 1.48, now it is 1, we want to bring it to 1. That is couple production rate. So by 2000, so couple production rate, we want to bring it to 60. Now at that point of time, it is only 23.6%. We want to bring back to 60. And family size, it is almost 5 members per family. We want to bring by 2000, 2.3. So antenatal coverage, it is almost 40%. So antenatal coverage by 2080, we want to bring it to 100%. Deliveries by trained birth attendants, it's almost 30% by 1983, and we want to brought it back, we want to bring it to 100%. So these are the specific goals which we want to bring down by 2000 AD. You can look at the immunization status coverage. You can see TT pregnant woman, it is 1983, it is 20. 2000, it is 100, so 100% we have to cover. DPT, that is diphtheria, pertussis and tetanus coverage, it is almost only 25%. We want to make it to 85%. Polio, that is infants, 1983 only 5%, whereas 2000 it is 85%. BCG infants, it is 65%. We want to make it to 85%. So these are all the specific goals. So India developed its primary healthcare model as a means to achieve health for all. So it is a 1978 primary healthcare centers were established. That is, the concept of primary healthcare came into limelight in 1978 following the Almaty Declaration, that is in USSR, Russia. So this Almaty Declaration was taken up by all the countries along with WHO. So the main thing is, if you want to reduce all the goals by 2000 AD, by only through primary healthcare centers only we can achieve all the goals. That's why they have started primary healthcare in 1978 following the Almaty Declaration by USSR. So primary healthcare, if you look at the definition of it, it is essential healthcare based on the practical, so scientific and technology made universally accessible to individuals and families in the community. So whatever the services are provided at the primary level, they must be practical, they must be very clear cut. So they must reach the public in time and scientifically sound. So whatever service they are providing, it should be scientifically sound and technology made technologically, that will be easily and made universally accessible. That means everybody can go to the primary health center and get the services whatever they want, and the individuals as well as the families. So whatever the need is there of that particular area, so they have to get it, all the services, from the primary health center. So that is the, as a primary healthcare definition. Through their full participation and at the cost the community and country can afford to maintain at every stage of their development the spirit of self-determination. So the people must be able to bear it properly, and then the people must be able to wear it properly, and the government must be in a position to wear it properly and see that all the services are provided to the people in that particular area. So the main concept of primary health is that the rural population of developing countries with at least the bare minimum of health services. So the rural people who are living in rural areas, they are not having any basic facilities are not available to them. That's why through primary health center, all the basic services must be provided to them. So underlying principles. So why the primary health care came into existence is social equality. That means all the people in the society must get an equal opportunity of healthcare services irrespective of caste, creed and money. Social equality. All the people living in that particular locality, they must get all the healthcare services equally irrespective of caste, creed and money. National wide coverage. All the primary health centers must be established throughout the country and everybody must get the services. Self-reliance. The people must realize that these are the services that are provided in the primary health center. So we have to go there and get the health services from the primary health centers. These are the underlying principles of, and then intersectoral coordination. That means all the sectors must come together, participate in the program, give their ideas and see that programs will become successful. And finally, it is community participation. So community participation. So I told you, keeping the people's health in people's hand. So this is all about the Health for All by 2000 AD. They brought out it has happened in the Almeta, and they brought out certain goals. They want to reduce those goals. To reduce that goals, what is their final conclusion is that they want to establish primary health centers for every 30,000 population, and then they are through that primary health centers they want to provide all the basic health needs to the people, so that all the healthcare indicators must be reduced. So I am going to stop here. I think all are present. I am giving attendance to each and everyone. So 136 present. 136. Roll number 136, please answer. Roll number 10.
Present, sir. 10 present, sir.
Anudya. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Are you there? So
yes, sir.
For how much population one primary health center will be located? Are you sleeping?
No, sir. 10,000, sir.
10,000, primary health center.
Thirty thousand
population. Roll number 36.
Yes, sir.
Who is that?
Sir, Gadhe Revant, sir.
Revant.
Yes, sir.
Are you there?
Yes, sir.
So what is Health for All by 2000 AD? What has happened? Broadly, you tell me just for two or three lines.
Sir, every country provides healthcare to every citizen. It's a community-wise health system, sir. Every person is involved in the health system.
Okay, you are not listening, just keeping the cell phone one side and you are doing your own work. Okay, thank you.
I need to receive
all present.